Okay, there we go. I actually am sitting comfortably, so we're all set. Oh, here, I have my glasses off. I might help you. How are you on sound, okay? I'll give you a little more. I won't be a brooding, intense character actor. I was around the military all my life, and I always remember my dad coming in his uniform and sometimes carrying a sidearm, you know? In fact, the first movie I ever remember seeing was From Here to Eternity. I was 5 years old.
Don't go out there, one, you'll get killed.
Put your pants on, you'll catch cold.
My dad was a very, very quiet man. I think the war, you know, I mean, he was terribly wounded twice. 2 Purple Hearts, Presidential Citation of Bravery. I mean, he went through a lot. There was actually a time, I'll never forget, we were in the officers' club. The band used to let me play the maracas. I was like 3, and I'd sit there and shake the maracas. And some drunk guy came over and kind of fooling around with me. And my dad didn't see it until he just looked as the guy kidding around hit me in the face with his fist and knocked me over by mistake. But this guy was drunk. And I'd never in my life seen my dad do this. He was always so quiet and so on. In one move, picked this guy literally by his shirt and threw him through the air against the mirror of the bar. He was just so stunned to see a guy hit his kidney. I mean, he just reacted like an animal instinct. But then I realized, oh, I understand when you've been in war for 4 years, you know, you don't think about it. You just see danger and you react.
Nobody's gonna do nothing. Anybody does any killing around here, I'll do it.
My history with this movie actually sort of informs why I think anybody should see it, because I had a very particular personal experience with it. My dad had just gotten back from Korea. So when he came back, we happened to go to the movie theater that week, and there was a little movie theater, just like the Last Picture Show, where they would show one movie, one time at night, all week long. This movie came out called From Here to Eternity. We ended up watching the movie every night for a week. Now, I was 5 and a half years old, and I didn't quite understand a lot of what was going on in the movie.
I'm the regimental boxing coach, you know.
Yes, sir.
Our regiment got beaten in the finals last December, but I mean to win this year.
I'm sorry, sir, I quit fighting.
And I'd sort of sleep on my mom's shoulder or in her lap or on my dad's shoulder in his lap for about, you know, the first hour and 30 minutes of the movie. And then just as the Japanese invaded Pearl Harbor, I'd wake up and think, ah, this is so cool. And I'd watch the war part. But along the way, even though I was a kid, I kind of noticed that there was something complex, you know, like, gee, that guy is kissing that other guy's wife. You know, I mean, I was kind of confused by the kind of adult nature of the movie at that age. I think what is most significant about the movie is the meaning of character and how character is truly destiny. Burt Lancaster, who plays Sergeant Milt Warden, he's the top kick of the company.
This here's a rifle outfit, Pruitt. You ain't supposed to enjoy yourself before sundown.
He's a lifer. He's the guy, the army is his whole life. He has nothing else but that. And now he's in the middle of having an affair with the worst woman on the face of the earth that he could ever imagine being involved with, his superior, Captain Holmes' wife, Deborah Carr.
My husband's been telling me a lot about you, Sergeant. He says you're very efficient.
Yes, ma'am.
What is it that makes you so efficient, Sergeant?
I was born smart, ma'am.
Where are you, darling? There she is. In fact, loving him as we speak. This is a major court-martial offense. It's possible it's the most famous, to this day, maybe one of the most famous sort of love scenes in the history of cinema, but certainly for its time, it was shocking and very much debated. And for her to be literally making love with Burt Lancaster in the ocean with the tide washing over them, which of course is a metaphor for just the literal sort of natural ferocity of sex. Yes, it's adultery, per se, but on the other hand, she's been given more true love and respect and care by Burt Lancaster than she got from her husband.
I never knew it could be like this. Nobody ever kissed me the way you do.
Montgomery Clift, who plays Corporal and then is busted down to Private, Robert E. Lee Pruitt, and his buddy, Angelo Maggio, Frank Sinatra, kind of hang out at this bar.
The New Congress Club.
That's right, hang out at the New Congress Club.
You got any prejudices against girls?
And Monty Clift gets involved with, where is she down here? Donna Reed. She's like the lady of the group, you know? She's the one that's sort of untouchable.
Don't tell me the princess is your style.
Donna Reed portrays a woman who is, now we know, a prostitute.
Hi. You busy? What's your name?
I'm Lorene.
What's kind of touching about it is that you realize there is almost an implicit shame in her life. which she'll never be able to overcome.
I won't marry you because I don't want to be the wife of a soldier.
She can't marry him because he's an army man, because her mother has always said that she should be, you know, a proper girl.
And I'll meet the proper man with a proper position. I'll make a proper wife who can run a proper home and raise proper children. And I'll be happy because when you're proper, you're safe.
You've got guts, honey. I hope you can pull it off.
Now, with a great actor like Montgomery Clift, who I think, if someone asked me who's my favorite actor in history, separating it by sex, it would be Betty Davis and Montgomery Clift. And I think what I loved about Montgomery Clift is everything looks so completely effortless. There's a scene where he's playing pool and he breaks the shot and all four balls go in. That's a perfect example of the way Montgomery Clift was as an actor. I'm sure he practiced that pool shot for days before he actually shot the scene. His talents were just, they were just a given. You know, he as a man, as a character. He was the bugler, he was a top boxer who refused to box. And Monty Clift is so isolated by everything that's happening around him, he was haunted by something. And Montgomery Clift did that better than anybody on earth. You never see acting like that in your lifetime. He is a man full of fire and turmoil and conflict.
Clean up the mess, Poot.
Clean it up yourself.
And doesn't wear his heart on his sleeve. He's accountable for his own actions.
I take it you're ready to apologize to Sergeant Galevich now?
No, sir, I'm not.
If I could play a role in this movie, without a doubt, it would be Robert E. Lee Pruitt.
Head and step, Pruitt.
I love characters whose torture is all internal, and that we as an audience have to go on that journey to understand it and to feel it and to sense it. And that's what was so great about that character.
Re-enlistment blues.
I think this movie, more than any other movie, says that it's okay to admire people, men and women, who are flawed but trying. Everybody's trying to jockey these sort of moral positions throughout. And we are sympathetic to each of them in a way. And I've never seen a film that really does that and at the same time entertains us so much. And the sense of foreboding that's in the film comes from that dilemma. It pays off, in fact, in the attack on Pearl Harbor. We know something's gonna happen here, but the explosion we expect does not come from within. It comes from above as the world goes insane. And I think it's one of the great motion pictures of all time because of it. This is James Woods, and you are watching Under the Influence on Turner Classic Movies, my favorite movie of all time, from here to eternity. This shirt that Montgomery Clift is wearing, you know, those ones with the palm trees and the surfers and all that stuff. That's, I mean, I have a picture of my dad, me, and my mom. That's what we used to wear.